This speech had been given just for information, names which were still under investigations. And because he was in a hurry, he went and tabled it in Parliament. Some of those people had not been found guilty. There was no sufficient evidence against them. And he tarnished names of very many innocent people. Then, on the other one, when we looked at that list, we found that a number of names were actually missing. Some names had been expunged from it. And I challenged him. And I said there was a name here of then the Minister for Devolution, which was here and had been removed. And I showed him where the name had been removed. Then came the NYS case. And I told him, I know what is happening in Kibera. I know how NYS was being looted. And I said, the suspect is so-and-so. They came out and said, I should leave that lady alone, that I should face them directly, himself and his deputy. He called a press conference in State House. When later on evidence emerged linking that minister with that scandal, deputy president went to a church in Githurai and said that that lady should stop speaking too much English. She must answer. You know, for your information, Joe, that lady is the candidate of Jubilee for gubernatorial elections in Kirinyaga.
So what would you have done, Mr. Odinga?
I would have taken action, a la Magufuli style. I would have Magufulied her.
So take the NYS case, for example. What would you have done about it that is different from